Hi guys, I'm back out at Harwood Forest for another solo wild camp, and I want to build a bit of a shelter with some kind of central heating. That's a bit too much of an exaggeration, but I want some kind of hot tent. I know I get called the warm weather wanderer, but who wants to come out when it's absolutely freezing bitter cold? Why rough it when you can smooth it? Do you know what I mean? And I'm thinking about building a tipi, because for me, I've built one in the past that's dead easy to make. Having an enclosed area, it's going to be more efficient for keeping warm. There's no need for big fires in the forest. It's not drawn to scale, obviously, but that's a 24 foot by 12. You can see the length is 2 times the width. And to do a proper tipi shape, it's essentially a cone, you know. You've got to kind of cut out a semicircle. You can see there how the tipi is basically a cone. The sides of the tipi will be 12 foot, but because I'll have them stretched out, the base, for around about 8 foot, it's going to be sitting a little bit lower, you know, which is quite a good height as well, because I want to be able to sit up in there, or even stand up in there. So I'm looking at poles that are about 13 foot, because you're going to have a little bit extra at the top of the lashing and the crossover. You can tell the dead standing trees, because they're much thinner and not as tall. And there's no like green foliage at the top, and I mean they're all planted at the same time, so you would expect to be all of, you know, like similar growth. That's how you can tell that it's, you know, it's not grown anymore, so it's dead standing basically. I've got my homemade buck saw that I made, but you know what it is, I forgot it's got a rubbish blade in. It's not working properly, I'll show you. The blade's bending all over. The problem is I can't get enough tension on it. Blade's already starting to buckle and warp, and it's getting snagged very easy. Nah. Plan B. Let's get this show on the road. It's gonna take forever, this. It's not so bad. If you get it on a good stroke and there's no warping in the blade, like that. I still think the problem is getting enough tension on the blade itself, or the lack of tension, I should say. One pole cut the length, two more to go. I feel happier getting the basic tripod up, because in a push I've got a basic shelter and it's already starting to drizzle a little bit, so I'm working against the clock here, guys. Let's get cracking on. I'm going to make a tripod lashing. I've got two different types of twine. I've got this stuff here. It's polypropylene. I think it's about 1.5 millimeters thick. But I think for the tripod, I'm going to need something a little bit thicker. So I've got this general purpose stuff. 20 kilograms breaking strain. So I'm not going to be hanging from it, but it'll do fine for a tripod lashing anyway. I start off with a timber hitch. Wrap this around 5 times. I think we've been thick coated as well, 4mm, better than the 1.5mm polypropylene. It's got some grip, you know what I mean? It's got like a braid around it. Wow, that's some weight. Oh, hey. Blooming heavy. Oh, ya bugger. It's getting it done safely. Oh, blooming taller than what I expected. Right, where am I gonna put it? There's barbed wire down there. I think over here. If you're gonna make it once, make it as big as you can. And it's just a case of finding some more pool. Well, that's all the poles in place. Three of them are lashed down, and the other three are just lying on top. And I've got to find a way of getting some more cordage, kind of like lock it in somehow, you know, each one. Maybe tie a stick, tuck it over, under over sort of thing. Just chuck them over a few more times from every angle, you know what I mean, till I get it like, till it looks reasonably tied down. You can see that what I've tried to do, I've tied a stick to the cordage and I've been chucking it over, just trying to bind it down a little bit better for the three poles that aren't lashed down. And I've just basically got to put the top round and then think about the raised bed, but I'm not going to have time today, so I'm just going to lie on the bottom in my bivvy. I've done as much as I can get done today. I need ladders. I can't get high enough to lift the top all the way to the top. So there's a massive hole, you know. It's going to be a shelter for the night. A very basic one. It's got legs on the bottom. I made a stove jack for it as well, but I can't find it. It's gone. I like these, how these go on the sides. You can dry your socks. This comes out, you cook on the top. Never used it before, don't know what it's like, but it's really sturdy built, and I've seen other people on YouTube using them. I thought I'd get it. Done a couple of burns of 20 minutes or so, just to build the temperature up a little bit, just to cure the paint. That's the top one. That's got a spark arrestor built in. I believe the chimney is about 8.5 foot tall. And what I'll do is I'll have to go and look for it. I'll put my stove jack, because it's kind of going through here. It's got an ash pan in there. See, I like the idea of having a window. But I'll have to go and try and find that stove jack. Well, I found it. It holds kitchen utensils. I think it's to put your like cutlery in to drain it. I think I got it from B&M or somewhere like that. Cut the base out so the chimney slides through. It's a bit of a tight fit. Ah, that's it. Got there in the end. Jubilee clip, held in the middle by bits of wire on four sides. Cheap stove jack, probably less than a fiver to buy. That starts to like, you know, move with the wind and touches the hot pipe and it starts a fire. I'm knackered, you know what I mean? If I don't wake up. I'm a little bit concerned when the wind flaps that it might just start touching the chimney later, so I've got to keep an eye on that. It's not the ideal solution, to be honest with you. So as you can see, guys, there's plenty of space in here. All I've got to do there is just open my dry bag and just roll my bivy out, my sleeping bag and my mattress is all in there, and my pillow as well. I'm going to have a stew, and I bought some diced beef, getting adventurous in the old age. I soak the potatoes overnight in water because they go black, you know, if they're out of water, but they look like they're okay actually. And I just got this, just a casserole mix, just for quickness, guys. I'm sick of eating lips and arseholes and things out of a tin, and it's not the most healthiest way to live. It just makes more sense cooking on the stove and keeping warm as well. I would say it's quite a luxurious wild camp for me. Obviously, with a little bit of a hot tent going on, I'm going to be toasty. Happy days. Lovely having a window, and I'm just gonna sleep here, guys, down here, and I can just keep feeding the logs on. Got a bit of a door there, I've just got to fold it back, but I can close that, and I've got some, well, I've got another small top there. I can patch up the gaps. I want a little bit of airflow just for the carbon monoxide. I quite like these, you know, it's a little bit extra area to put stuff. Ooh. That's hot. Stupid thing to do that, like. Gets hot quite quickly. Oh, the heat coming off that. This is, oh, honestly, this is just like, this is fantastic, this, like. Now I'm supposed to brown that first with a teaspoon of oil, but I haven't got any oil, so. It's just gonna have to get browned on its own. Just fits. I'll put the plate back on when I'm slow cooking it. This is definitely where it's at. The trick, you know, of getting a lovely tasty meat is to brown it, because that just, it kind of caramelizes the meat, and it brings out a lot of the flavors. broke the bottom of the bag to get at the onions, because we're at the bottom. I'm just going to drop them in. And I can caramelise the onions as well. I just guesstimated when I put the water in. I'm not going to need all of it, to be honest with you. Just a bit of everything. I've got peas as well, but I think they can go in nearer the end because they'll get out of the mush. Same with the mushrooms. I could probably, they're in there somewhere. Maybe just put them in a little bit, maybe it's in about an hour's time. And the secret weapon. The seeds are very hot. Cayenne peppers. I switched the light off before and the chimney's glowing, it's that hot. The flame is at the very back. It seems to be where it's drawn the most. And there's hardly any flame towards the front where my pot is sitting on the top. Oh, that's a bit better, isn't it? It's probably too much there now. I do like the idea of cooking on the stove and getting warm at the same time. The only thing is, unless you've got a lot of seasoned wood, it's a big faff and you've got to constantly watch it and you're nursing it all the time, keeping an eye on it in case it gans out. Well, not gans out, but yeah, when the temperature drops, it's, you know, it's not cooking anymore, the stew just cools down. But it's ticking over there nicely there now. I don't know what to make of this camp. It's been a lot of hard work and I still feel like I'm grafting. Even though it's, you know, I should be chilling, I should be enjoying the evening. But this is just, I suppose it's just all new. It's new stove, new setup, different kind of shelter, you know, teething trouble. At some point, it has touched. See? The wind's caught it. And on that side as well. I'm gonna have to be so careful. Once my meal is cooked, I'm letting it go out. It's a forecast for the temperature of the night. It's to go down to 7 or 8 degrees Celsius. So it's not cold, basically. I'm quite happy with the amount of space that I've got in here. You know, plenty of area for two to keep in here, or maybe three. Well, three people at a push. You'd probably even get four people in, but it'd be like sardines. I've got me dodgy glasses on. These are my reading glasses. I look very intelligent with these ones on, don't I? I look bright, haven't I, when I've got these on. I look like a librarian or something. Still a bit too hot, like it's gonna burn me lips. Still a bit tough. The meat's not as tender as what I thought it might. And it's absolutely burning me mouth, that chili pepper. It beats meatballs and mash and ravioli out of a tin. Oh, that's beautiful. And that's what it's all been worth waiting for. The graft I've put in the day. And now I've got the chance to just eat and chill. But it's bedtime. I think it's gone 10 o'clock now. But I'm obviously, I still can't relax till that fire totally dies down. How quick was that, guys? Just roll it out.
and I'm ready to just jump into my sack and go to sleep. And I'm going to be lovely and warm in all those layers. Thermarest, bivy, and another mat underneath. Happy days. Absolutely tons of room in here. So that's me definitely going away now, guys. Going to switch off and go to sleep. I'll catch us all tomorrow. Get up and do a wild camp, and you know it makes sense. You know it makes sense. Morning. Well, the rain came last night in the centre of the shelter is soaking wet, but I'm in my bivvy, so I'm nice and warm. I only wish I could have been able to get up to the top there and made that hole a bit smaller. I banked my wood burner right up last night because I wasn't really tired, and I thought, well, I'll just keep an eye on it till it dies down, and then, you know, I'll try not to fall asleep before I know that it's going out. That was when it was sort of roaring away, there was sparks coming out and landing on the top. So I think the spark arrestor isn't doing a very good job. At one point, there was I could see a little glowing hole in the top. I don't know if it would have started a fire, but it started to melt the top. I was a little bit concerned. I just stayed awake till I knew the fire was going out. And then it started to rain anyway, so, you know, I thought, ah, well, everything's got to be fine. Well, it's a bit of a fucky morning. You can look at it two ways, it's either beautiful or it's creepy. Well, as we all packed up and ready to go, I've got quite a lot of weight on my shoulders here, so I'm gonna hang around. It's been a good one, totally enjoyed it. Today, the fog and the rain, it just makes the place feel even more spookier than it is. So what I think I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna go back to the car, I'm gonna have it just wander around and just look for some, you know, some nice pictures to take, because I think that could be some photography opportunities in the forest today. Not that I'm a photography channel, by the way, guys, but you know what I mean. Right, I'm going to get away, guys. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you all in the next one. Get out and do it a wild camp, and you know it makes sense. You know it makes sense. Because it does.